Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, March 19th, we'll remember one model evangelist, Philip, from the Bible. Acts 21:8 says, Philip the evangelist, who was one of seven. Philip was the only blessed person who was given this title, evangelist. He was not anointed to become an evangelist, but to serve in the church. Later, due to his close association with God, he was made an evangelist. If we could make Christ's last command as the first priority in our lives, we all would become like Philip and thus make the Lord, who sacrificed himself for us, happy. We'll learn a few lessons from his life. Acts 6:5 says, he was filled with faith and Holy Spirit. The apostles chose seven people of good reputation to work in the church. An evangelist should always work with the help of Holy Spirit. That's the lesson we have to learn. Second one is, Philip worked along with the other seven selected men. He volunteered to serve just like how Jesus taught his disciples by washing their feet. In John 13:4-5, Jesus taught his disciples the importance of servant leadership. Philip learned that. We also should learn it. Third one is, Philip went to Samaria as an evangelist. An evangelist should always go to preach the word to the people who are downtrodden and unaccepted ones, like the Samaritans. In those days, Samaritans were treated as untouchables, and none of the Jews, they wished to go to Samaria. But Philip offered to go there as an evangelist. And he changed a lot of Samaritans and brought them to Christ. Fourth point is, Philip preached Christ to them, Acts 8:5 says, which is very important. People prefer listening to fables, but we should preach Christ only, since the gospel is Christ-centered and we are saved only by having faith in Jesus Christ. This is very important in an evangelist's life, or else any believer's life. Fifth one is, Philip didn't hesitate to leave his ministry at Samaria and run in the wilderness to preach to an Ethiopian when the angel asked him to do so. We see this in Acts 8:26-30. An evangelist always should follow the instructions of God. Sixth is, Philip preached in all the cities. It's written in Acts 8:40. Philip was not satisfied with one or two souls, but he went on and on. Seventh is, Philip hosted Paul and his co-workers for many days. It's written in Acts 21:8-10. He had a good family and home atmosphere. Four of his daughters were evangelists also. They were prophetess. Thus, we learn a lot of lessons from the life of Philip. He should be a model evangelist to all. Let's pray. Lord, thank you, Lord, for teaching us about Philip the evangelist. If we want to follow your last command, we should be evangelists too. Please help us to be so. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen.